Well, it's Thursday morning, shade before 10. I'm on my way to the knife gig. A lady called me yesterday, said that she had some knives she wanted me to pick up this morning. I'm going to meet her at the Food Line parking lot on the way. She said, I got a lot of knives. And you know, in this business, that don't mean you can't tell what that means. God knows. If it's anything like the lady last week, man alive. Anyway, we'll see what that gets to in a few minutes. It's a beautiful day. Not as warm as I'd like it to be working outside, but that's the way life is. When you're dumb, you gotta be tough. Stand by. Dumb. Well, I just picked up the knives from the lady. It's kind of heavy. It's wrapped up. It's wrapped up kind of tight. We'll wait till we get over to the market where we can got more time. See what's in this bag. Okay, we're all set up. Let's look in this bag and see what's in here. Come on, there we go. It's like a family of heckles or woodstocks or something. No, that's no heckle, that's a chop. Wait for the jet plane. That's a nice heckle there. Another heckle. I call them heckles. I know that's not what you call them, but that's what I call them. That's three. That's four. Five. And one's Chinese Santuco. Made in China. Stainless. So, what have we got? We got six this morning to start with. And I got another lady called, said she's bringing some over. So maybe we'll be a little busy today. We'll have to see how it goes. Stand by. Now yesterday when I went and picked up my flyers, posters I should say, for the Taste Unlimited gig, I picked up I sharpened his cutter blades for his printing machine that cuts the stock. You know, it's a blade cutter. Great big thing. You might remember I did one for him before. And he put that one in yesterday and gave me this one to sharpen up. It's a big, long, wide thing. Like a chisel ground blade. Thick, heavy steel. Okay, we got that to do. Take it out here in the light where the sun is shining on it. Got a few little nicks in it too. He said she was starting to grab a lot. Well, hellfire, we got our first walk-up customer. We weren't expecting many walk-up customers, but we got one. We got two KitchenAid knives and a nice Gerber. Gerber, that's right. Cool, stand by. I got a dilemma, so to speak. This cutter blade, it's got some really nasty sticky stuff on it. I've been working on it for 10 minutes with this nylon wheel here. And it's just this scratching it with my alcohol. So I went over to the restaurant right over here and got one of them nylon scrubby things. I'm going to go to work on it with that. So that was it. That was a trick, that green scrubby thing. She's just like brand new now. All I got to do is sharpen her up. Cool. I like it. The plan comes together. Okay. Thank you, Princess Anne Grill. Yesterday I was honeydewing all day long and I should have been spinning. Beaver went to the button patch and found a cool, I mean a super cool button. British Merchant Marine button. got a crown on it, but a big anchor, it runs through the crown. I'll show you a picture of it at the end there. I mean, it was a nice button. Man, I'd like to have that in my scoop. Anyway, I went thrift store shopping when I was riding around yesterday, and I found this old, like, fish fillet knife. You scale the fish with that thing right there, and, you know, it's kind of cool. So I bought it. And then I found a nice Mundial. Be a nice fillet knife, too. And then I found a super-duper Henkel. Hey! Serrated knife. This is the best of it. The egg sandwich lady. 8-inch. Looks like it's brand almost new. And then I bought this is a F. Dick knife made in Germany. But it's made for Johnson & Wales. Right up there it says Johnson & Wales Superior. Nice boner. Cool. I got to sharpen them up now. Since I'm finished with all of my customers. So far, that was all I've had. What you saw earlier. Okie dokie. Stand by. Man, oh man, it's 10 minutes past 2. And I usually stay till 2. Well, I was thinking about cleaning it up, and this car pulled up. A returning customer named Matthew. Look, got two nice Japanese knives. One's a Shun. But you can see it, if you can see that mate, you got two major chips right there. Microchips, you see it? That's just the creature. Nothing to do with the nature of these beasts. They do that. But you'll clean right up. Pretty knife. I like it. Blade looks pretty good. And we have some nice, I don't know what they are. Look like Henkels to me. Yep, Henkels. I think a whole family of them. Uh-oh. Cathalon. Cathalon's moved into the neighborhood here. Matthew, what are you doing with these things? And another Heckle. We got three Heckles, two Shuns, and three Califanos. That's the lady that has the pot pies. Okay, I got to go to work. Dun, 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 dun. Well, I just finished up that last set of knives. Two Heckles, the three Cephalons, and one from China. And the two Japanese knives. Nice. Stand by. Got to clean up. Well, I'm home at Rancho Max. I get home and I got knives at home in the mail. Look at that. I got a Christmas card from Mr. Thomas, a.k.a. Penny Digger. You know, most of y'all, well, not everybody knows Penny Digger, but most everybody knows him. Penny Digger on YouTube. And I got one from my buddy Ron in New Jersey. Gold Digger Detectors. And here, this is a unique item in here. I've never actually seen one of these before except in a video. You remember my buddy Fred who was here visiting for a while, detecting from California? Well, this is his tuna fillet knife. It's called a Bubba, B-U-B-B-A. If you don't know what a Bubba is, you can Google it and see it in live and living color on YouTube. I've never actually seen it. We're going to take it out of here in a minute and look at it, if we can figure out how this box works. Bubba knife. I think they make two or three kinds, but this is strictly for tuna. Hold on a minute. Let me see if I can figure out how to get this out of here. Simple lid. All I had to do was pick it up. Seemed complicated for a minute. Come out of there, Bubba. You turkey damn thing, you. Look at this, baby. Don't ask me what that is. That's just on there. I guess it's a wrist thing for your wrist. So it won't sink, maybe, or something. Float. See, it's orange. I can tell you that. Good googa mooga. Looks like that knife I did today, just a little bigger. Got little finger holes for your fingers to go in. Ergonomics. See what this says right here. I'll get my magnifier glass out here. Bubba Blade. Who didn't know that? Bubba Blade. I don't see where she needs sharpening too much. I think he's got a Lansky, I think he told me. I don't know, though. She's a little dull up here. We actually use her a lot on the tip. Back in the back here, she's pretty sharp. Dull. Not overly dull, just a little dull. I guess this thing is some kind of stainless. I don't see anything on it. I'll get a closer look at it in a little while. Bubba Blade. What a taquito. Ooh. Look, look at that, a taquito. A carnivore. What are you doing? You looking at Jack? Huh? Hey, what are you doing? You hungry? That's what you're in here for, because you're starving to death, fat man dude. That's fat man dude. Stand by. Pretty cool. I like it. Mr. Ron. Mr. Thomas, Penny Digger. I like it. Oh man, stand by.